Hariyom, my dear students, please follow the instructions given by the government to fight against COVID-19. Whenever you go outside, don't forget to wear mask. Avoid touching your eyes, nose and mouth frequently. Now I am here to teach you the second part of the poem Wind, written by Subramanya Bharathi. In the previous class, we have studied the first stanza. In the first stanza, we have learned the poet requests the wind to come slowly. Later, he complains that, in spite of his request, the wind blew strongly and destroyed everything. Now, let's see the next stanza. All of you take your literature reader. Second stanza. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings. Frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Now let's see line by line. You are very clever at poking fun. Poking here means laughing at. Poking fun at weaklings. You are very clever. The poet says that the wind is very clever at laughing at the weak people. And frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives and crumbling hearts. That means here, listen, the word crumbles repeated many times in this poem. The word crumbles repeated many times in this poem. This shows that everything crumbles in the face of earth. In the face of strong wind. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. What is the meaning of the word winnow? Winnowing means separate grain from husk. But here, the god, the wind is considered to be god. The wind god separates strong and weak people and destroys the weak. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Then what is the meaning of the second stanza? In the second stanza, the poet says that the wind makes fun of the weaklings and crumbling everything. The word crumbles repeated many times in this poem to show that everything crumbles in the face of a strong wind. The wind separates strong and weak people and destroys the weak people easily. Okay, understand? Listen, the wind makes fun of the weaklings and crumbling everything. Everything destroys, everything crumbles in the face of a strong wind. The wind god separates the strong and weak people and destroys the weak easily. Now let's see the third stanza. He won't do what you tell him. So come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. He won't do what you tell him. The poet says that the wind does not obey us. So, we should build strong homes and close the doors firmly so that the wind cannot get inside. Listen, the wind does not obey us. So, we should build strong homes and close the doors firmly so that the wind cannot get inside. Listen, he won't do what you tell him. So, come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body, make the heart steadfast. Do this, the wind will be friends with us. The poet also says that we should also make our bodies strong and hearts firm to face the challenges in our life. We should also make our bodies strong and hearts firm to face the challenges in our life. The wind is the symbol of the problems in our life. Sometimes the wind comes slowly or gently, and sometimes it comes strongly. That means the wind is like the problems in our life. So we should be bold enough to face the challenges in our life. So the poet requests us to build strong houses and close the doors firmly so that the wind cannot get inside. We should also make our bodies strong and hearts firm to face the challenges in our life. Then if we are doing so, the wind will make friendship with us. Once we are bold enough, we can easily overcome all the adversities in our life. Listen, the wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. The wind blows out weak fires and supports the strong fires. The wind supports the strong fires and blows out the weak fires. According to the poet, the friendship with the wind is good. but we should praise the wind every day for getting gentle wind. Listen once more. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings, frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. He won't do what you tell him. So, come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. Make the heart steadfast. Do this and the wind will be friends with us. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. Then what we have seen today, in the second stanza, the poet says that the wind makes fun of the weak people and crumbles everything. The word crumbling repeated many times in the poem to show that everything crumbles in the face of a strong wind. The wind separates the strong and the weak people and destroys the weak easily. The wind does not obey us. So the poet requests us to build strong houses and close the doors firmly so that the wind cannot get inside. We should also make our body strong and our heart firm to face the challenges in our life. If we are doing so, the wind will make friendship with us. Once we are bold enough, we can overcome all the adversities in life easily. Again, at the end of the poem, the poet says that the wind supports the strong fires and extinguishes the weak fire. So, friendship with the wind is good. So, we should praise wind for getting every day. Getting the soft, gentle wind every day. Then all of you understand? Listen once more. In the second stanza, the poet says that the wind makes fun of the weak people and crumbling everything. The word crumbling repeated many times in this poem. Why? Everything crumbles in the face of a strong wind. The wind gods separate strong and the weak people and destroys the weak easily. The wind does not obey us. So the poet requests us to build strong houses and close the doors firmly so that the wind cannot get inside. So we should also make our bodies strong and the hearts firm to face the challenges in our life. Once we are bold enough, we can easily overcome all the adversities in our life. The wind supports the strong fires and extinguishes the weak fires. The friendship with the wind is good, but we should praise the wind every day. Then in the last part of the poem, we have seen that the wind is the symbol of the problems in our life. Then in our life, we have to face many problems. Sometimes the wind comes slowly and sometimes it blows strongly. Like that, the problems in our life is also in the same way. So what we should do? Then we should be able to face the challenges in our life. Once we are bold enough, we can overcome all the difficulties in our life easily. Then what we learn from this story? Listen, face challenges and hardship with courage and firm determination. We should face challenges and hardship with strong determination and courage. Listen, face challenges and hardship with courage and firm determination. What is the moral of this poem? Face challenges and hardship with courage and strong determination. Hriday, can you summarize this poem? Okay, that means wind, sometimes it comes slowly, sometimes it blows out strongly like the problems in our life. That means we can expect problems in our life at any time. So we should be bold enough to face all the challenges in our life. Listen, now quickly move on to the important poetic devices used in the poem, wind. Listen, first one is anaphora. Anaphora means two or more lines repeated with the same word. Two or more lines begin with the same word. What do you mean by anaphora? Two or more lines begin with the same word. Listen, in this poem, lines 3, 4, 2, 3, 4 begin with the word dawn. 2, 3, 4 begin with the word dawn and 6, 7, 8 begin with the word you. So the poetic devices used here is anaphora. Two or more lines begin with the same word. Next one is repetition. The word crumbling repeated many times in this poem. So we can say that the poetic device repetition. The same word is repeated in the same line. So, repetition. Next one is personification. This may be a new one for you. The personification means attributes human qualities to something non-human. Attributes human qualities to something non-human. Then here the wind is non-human, but here the poet attributes human qualities to wind. So we can say that the poet has used personification here. Then listen once more. First one, anaphora. The lines 2, 3, 4 begin with the word dawn. 6, 7, 8 begin with the word you. Repetition. Crumbling. The same word is repeated same many times in the same line. Personification. Wind. The wind is personified here. That means attributes human qualities to something non-human. I think all of you understand this lesson. I will send you the notes through Google Classroom. Thank you all.